God is good all the time.
Shalom, good morning church, and to all our beloved viewers out there, we hope that all of you are staying safe and staying strong in the Lord. Well, surely indeed, this is my privilege and honor to be your presider for this week. By the way, my name is Brother Eric Ng. Indeed, we are thankful to the Lord for a wonderful and anointed FGCCI Media Weekly Service last week, especially the message delivered by Brother Anthony Narendran entitled God in Our Midst. Let us remember the words of God taken from the book of Psalms chapter 46 verses 1 to 5. It reads, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling. There is a river whose streams shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. Our theme for this year is Be Strong in the Lord, found in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 10. Let us continue to be strong in the Lord together in these challenging times. May the good Lord continue to use us to be a blessing to many and even unto the nations. Amen. Well, this is the latest update here, whereby Selangor and Kuala Lumpur is back to phase 1 of the National Recovery Plan, except for 4 specific areas, and other states are moving towards phase 2. Let us continue to exercise greater caution and self-discipline to stay safe by the grace of God and continue to keep our nation in earnest prayers for a successful vaccination program till the pandemic is over. Let us meditate on God's promises found in the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 9. It reads, Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Praise the Lord. Many thanks once again for all your earnest prayers and your faithful support for our Digital Discipleship Church program. By the way, our presenters for this week are as follows. Scripture reading will be presented by Sister Florence Macalino. Worship leading will be led by Sister Maricel and Brother Carlos J. The exhortation will be given by Brother Julius Bonifacio. Praise the Lord. Prayer for the nation of Afghanistan will be led by Pastor Irfan from the FGCCI Mustafa Park, Lahore. The Word of God will be shared by Brother William Yip from the FGCCI Main Church, who is also our media producer. Last but not least, the closing and the benediction will be conducted by Reverend Dr. David Kwe, the Senior Pastor and Spiritual Overseer of the FGCCI. Praise the Lord. Hope that all of you will be abundantly blessed this year. Stay tuned, church, and may God bless us all. Stay safe wherever you are. Do enjoy the media service until the end. God bless you richly and abundantly. Happy watching!
Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. In the city of our God, in his holy mountain. Beautiful in elevation, the joy of the whole earth is Mount Zion on the sides of the north, the city of the great king. God is in her palaces, he is known as her refuge. For behold, the kings assemble, they pass by together. They saw it, and so they marvel. They were troubled, they hastened away. fear took hold of them there, and pain as of a woman in bird pangs, as when you break the ship of Tarshish with an east wind. As we have heard, so we have seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God will establish it forever. We have thought, O God, on your loving kindness in the midst of your temple, according to your name, O God. So is your praise to the ends of the earth. Your right hand is full of righteousness. Let Mount Zion rejoice. Let the daughters of Judah be glad because of your judgments. Walk about Zion and go all around her. Count her towers, mark well her bulwarks. Consider her palaces, that you may tell it to the generation following. For this is God, our God, forever and ever, who will be our guide even to death. May the Lord bless the reading of His word. Amen. God bless everyone.
God is good. God is good.
Good morning, church, and all our viewers. I hope that you're all staying safe and staying blessed in the presence of the Lord every day. Come and join us as we worship the Lord through song entitled Love to Worship You. Hallelujah.
My desire longs to please you, Jesus. Lord, we glorify your name. We lift you up.
Father. We glorify you, Holy Spirit. We praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. We glorify your name. Holy Spirit, fill our hearts. Hallelujah. We bless your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for this day. Thank you for this wonderful day, Jesus. Thank you for your love, for your grace, Jesus. We give you back all glory, honor, and praises. In Jesus' name, amen.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart.
I'm Brother Julius, and I want to share it to you on how to overcome fear. We all have fears in life, or at least things or places that make us very uncomfortable. Fear is a natural, powerful, and primitive human emotion. It involves a universal biochemical response, as well as a high individual emotional response. Fear alerts us to the presence of danger or the threat of harm, whether that danger is physical or psychological. In the Bible, there are three ways we can learn how to overcome fear. Number one, meditation of God's Word. In Romans 10 verse 17 says, "So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God." By meditating on God's Word, our faith will be established. And in Joshua 1 verse 9, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and good of courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." Our faith will rise from within, and it will cast out fear when we meditate in God's Word. Praise the Lord. Number two, fellowship with people of faith. In Ecclesiastes 4 verse 9, "Two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor." When we fellowship with the people of faith, we will be encouraged, our faith will be renewed. It's like having a bonfire. Number three, the truth will set us free. In John 8, verse 32 says, "And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." Many people recently is fearful of adverse effect and COVID-19 vaccine hesitation that makes us paralyzed and not thought of getting vaccinated. We should face them, but how should we face them? Yes, my brothers and sisters, by knowing the truth and not listening to fake news or fear news. We have to investigate, find and search more information about your vaccines. Changes these negative thoughts into a positive thought, because knowing that these vaccines are well tested and approved by the World Health Organization, even if there is a side effect, it will be temporary and it will be protected by being vaccinated, unless due to a certain medical condition and we are advised by our doctors not to be vaccinated, which is an exception. In conclusion, in our Christian life, we are taught to cast our worries to God. In Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, "God promises to be with us, not to be discouraged, because He is our God." In 41 verse 10 says, "Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up and help you with my victorious hand." The first reason why we should not be afraid is He promised that He is with us. He is with you. He is with you all the time, wherever you go and wherever you do. He promised that He is with you. The second reason not to be discouraged is, for I am your God. Not only just God of Elijah, God of Moses, King David, but is your God, personal. You believe in Him, you trust in Him, and rest in Him. Great reasons to be encouraged and do not be fear is, He's strengthening you. He will sustaining you and helping you with His victorious right hand. My brothers and sisters, God wants to bless us and protect us by being vaccinated. If you're afraid like King David in Psalm 56 verse 3, when I'm afraid, I will trust in you. So my brothers and sisters, do not be afraid of anything. Investigate and know the truth, because the truth will set us free. Trust in Him and rest in the promises of God, and our fear will turn into faith. Amen. God bless us all. Stay safe always.
All the time, through the darkest night, His light will shine. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. خدای قدوس رب الفاج سرابر خدا تیرا شکر ہو تیرے نام کی تعریف و تمجید ہو تجھے محبت کا خالق اور مالک راسی خدا ہے الہوں کا الہ شاہوں کا شاہ عظیم خدا ہے تو آج اس وقت میں آج شام میں دعا کرتا ہوں خداوند افغانستان کے لیے کہ خداوند ان لوگوں کے ساتھ ہو ان لوگوں کو بائی کر دے جو اس وقت خداوند جنگ کی حالت میں ہے اب میں دعا کرتا ہوں کہ خداوند جنگ کو ختم کر دے کیونکہ تو صلح اور سلامتی کا شہزادہ ہے یہوہ پاک خدا میں منت کرتا ہوں ان لوگوں کے درمیان سلامتی پیدا کر ان کے ذہنوں کو تبدیل کر دے ان کی سوچوں کو تبدیل کر دے ان کے درمیان کہ خداوند ان کے ذہن تبدیل ہو جائے ان کی سوچیں تبدیل ہو جائے ان کی سخت دلی کو دور کر دے تاکہ خداوند افغانستان کے اندر ایک نیا ریوائول آ جائے اور دعا کرتا ہوں محنت کرتا ہوں التجا کرتا ہوں یہ بابا خدا تو صلح اور سلامتی کا شہزادہ ہے افغانستان کے اندر محبت اور سلامتی کو نازل کر دے محبت اور سلامتی افغانستان کے اندر آ جائے اے خداوند ہم پوری ایف جی سی سی آئی ٹیم دعا کرتی ہے افغانستان کے لیے کہ خدا افغانستان کے اندر تیری سلامتی آنا شروع ہو جائے جنگ اور قتل وہاں سے جاتے رہے خدا بندہ نشے کی لانتے وہاں سے جاتے رہے خدا بندہ وہاں پر جو کچھ بھی ہو رہا ہے اے خدا بندہ پلیز کا جو منصوبہ ہے وہ پورا نہ ہونے پائے بلکہ وہاں پر خدا بند تیرا جلال ظاہر ہو تیری قوت ظاہر ہو تیری حشمت ظاہر ہو اے خدا افغانستان کے اندر سلامتی کو لا افغانستان کے اندر محبت کو لے کر افغانستان کے اندر صلح سلامتی کو لے کر خدا بندہ میں دعا کرتا ہوں جنگ کی حالت کو وہاں پر ختم کر دے خدا بندہ وہاں پر بائبل کو وہاں پر بائبل کی تعلیم کو انجیل کی منادی کو خوشخبری کی تعلیم کو پھیلا دے خدا بندہ وہاں پر تیرے لوگ جا کر انجیل کی کرے خدا بندہ مشن کو پورا کرے خدا بندہ گو ٹو مشن بن جائے خدا بندہ تاکہ وہاں پر جا کر نئی تبدیلی آ جائے خدا بندہ افغانستان کے اندر انجیل کی خوشخبری پھیلنا شروع ہو جائے خدا بندہ میں دعا کرتا ہوں منت کرتا ہوں التجا کرتا ہوں وہاں کے لوگوں کی حالت کو تبدیل کر دے خدا بندہ وہاں کے لوگوں کی حالت چینج ہو جائے خدا بندہ وہاں کے لوگوں کی حالت تبدیل ہو جائے یسوع کے نام سے میں دعا کرتا ہوں منت کرتا ہوں التجا کرتا ہوں یہوہ خدا کہ خداوند اس دعا کے وسیلہ سے افغانستان کے اندر نئی تبدیلی آ جائے صلح سلامتی آ جائے یسوع مسیح کے نام سے آمین آمین
Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And to the viewers out there, glad to have you join us. Let us come together and commit this time into the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, for this day. We thank you, Father, for your presence right now. We ask, O Lord, for that you forgive us of all our sins, O Lord. Forgive us, Lord, for all the things that we have committed knowingly or unknowingly. Lord, cleanse us once again with the blood of Jesus. We ask, O Father, that you open our ears today, O Lord. Open our ears that we will hear and listen to your word. And Father, help me, O Lord, as your servant to deliver your word accurately, to deliver as in the way that you want to speak to your people. Not a word more, not a word less, but exactly what you want to tell your people, O Lord. Father, I ask, O God, for your anointing and for your glory to overwhelm each and every one of us who have tuned in. Lord, thank you for your presence once again. In Jesus' victorious name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Here we are, already half a year gone into 2021. In fact, we are approaching towards the end of July already. Now, from the beginning of the year, we've been listening, we've been hearing, we never miss. If you tune into the media service, you never miss the theme of the year, the theme for 2021. Be strong in the Lord, found in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10. I cannot help but to wonder the progress that each of us may have or may not have made in the past 6 months. Have we grown stronger? Are we stagnant? Or have we fallen behind? Whichever way, spiritual growth requires transformation by the renewing of the mind. Are we able to discern the will of God? Or are we being willful ourselves? The bitter reality is that despite knowing that God is in our midst and everything has its own time, some of us just cannot get out of difficult situations, no matter how much we pray, no matter how long we pray for. Many of us are in a waiting season. There is something we need. There is something to look forward to. There's something that we desire. Some of you are waiting for some kind of a healing. Some are waiting for some kind of a breakthrough. Many more are waiting to return to stable employment. I myself am waiting to be able to worship freely in church with the fellow saints every Sunday. But one absolute certainty is we can never fully understand the way, how, or why God works at different times and seasons. For his thoughts are not our thoughts, nor our ways his ways. We are only expected to trust and believe that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. Regardless whether you have grown spiritually stronger or not, it is time to pause and a time to reflect at what shapes you. Whatever makes you or molds you to be who you are and where you are in life today. We have to look inwards to learn what made you stronger in the Lord or what hindered your progress. Re-examine what propelled you forward or what kept you back. Don't look to the external circumstances. Don't look to the pandemic. Don't look to the economy, but just turn inwards. There is a saying, we cannot change the direction of the wind, but we can change. We can adjust the sails. We cannot change the direction of the wind, but you can adjust your sails. Simply put, there are things which are beyond our control, and there are things that we can make adjustments to cope with whatever given circumstances there may be. Things beyond our control, we surrender to the Lord and let him fight for us. Whatever we can control, it is time we need to reconsider if we are doing the right thing or whether we need a different strategy. The message for today is what shapes you. It is not about who you are. It is not about your background, nor what have you achieved in life. What shapes you is about what defines the person you are today or who you will become tomorrow. It is important that we understand this, what moves us to be where we are in life today. I will share three simple keys on what shapes you to be who you are and where you are today. These are by no means the only points for reflection, but they are a starting point. Number one, your feelings, your emotions, your attitudes. Have you noticed that whenever you feel joyful, you tend to be optimistic? You tend to be positive, full of energy. But on the other hand, when you feel down, life seems so dark and so gloomy. It's like it's hopeless, there is no future. Everything becomes so negative that you may not even want to live another day. I'm sure many of us will have experienced such days, good or bad. Or how about when someone offends you? You can choose to think you have the right to be angry when you're offended. And if you focus on this right to be angry, you will definitely and also naturally feel angry. Your state of emotions become a feeling of anger inside. But on the other hand, if you choose to overlook the offense, you keep your cool, you keep calm. So your emotions, your feelings are important. And it is important for us to understand ourselves. In short, whatever starts in the mind may determine how we feel and therefore also affect our attitude or behavior towards people or towards situations. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 26, it says, "Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath, nor give place to the devil." Verses 26 and 27. It is all right to get angry, but deal with it. Get over it. Don't dwell on it. However, you also need to discern what you feel. Whether is it scriptural, whether is it in line with what the Bible teaches us. Because whatever starts in the mind or the heart doesn't only remain there. Your feelings are a precursor to something else. And this brings us to Luke chapter 6 verse 45. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, his mouth speaks. So whatever conceived in the heart does not remain inside. Sooner or later, you pour it out. Which leads us to point number two. Speech. What you say. Now we all know death and life are in the power of the tongue. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 21. It's easy to quote, very easy, but do we really care about what we speak? Do we really think before we speak? The book of James in chapter 3 verses 1 to 12 talks about the tongue. But let me draw your attention to verses 7 to 9. James chapter 3 verse 7. For every kind of beast and bird, of reptile and creature of the sea, is tamed, and has been tamed by mankind. But no man can tame the tongue. It is an unruly evil, full of deadly poison. With it we bless our God and Father, and with it we curse men, who have been made in the similitude of God. So you see here, the tongue is a powerful tool. And you've got to be careful when you handle it. Be aware that your spoken words can be a blessing or can be a curse. Your spoken words can be truth or gossip. Be very careful, especially when handling the Word of God. Now, years ago, as a young Christian, a sister from the church one day suffered from constipation. She tried and she used those constipation pumps, but they didn't help her. So she asked if I could pray for her. Of course, I said, sure, and I prayed. A few hours later, she was screaming at me. She was very, very upset. I wondered, why? What happened? It turned out she kept going non-stop to the bathroom. Now, anyone with diarrhea will tell you that it is tiring, it is dehydrating, even inconvenient. Your knees literally go weak. It is hard enough just to stand upright, let alone going to the toilet, to the bathroom so many, many times in that few short hours. So she asked me, what kind of prayer is that? Honestly, I don't know. All I knew was that just presenting a petition to God on her behalf. To me, it was just a short, simple prayer. It went something like, if I can recall, it went something like this. God, heal her. Open the passage. Release it. Let it out. In Jesus' name, amen. That's all. Very short, very simple. Believe me, God heard. God answered. Whatever that needs to be flushed out, kept coming out. It didn't stop. It didn't stop there. Even when there was nothing left, she was still going to the bathroom repeatedly. At that time, I didn't know if it was a joke. I also didn't know much about prayer. But that spoken prayer, over time I realized, was like a double-edged sword, bringing both relief and pain afterwards. The one thing I learned is that just as important it is to be careful of our words, our speech, our prayer also needs to be specific. Since then, I've never said another constipation prayer. And if I do, I will know that I have to command it to stop. Amen? So you see, blessing and cursing can be from the same lips. Sometimes we need to change our attitudes before we even begin to speak. For example, if you tell somebody, you are stupid, you are actually unconsciously cursing that person. So at times we need to change whatever is inside our hearts so that we speak blessings. Again, I say, be very careful about what comes forth out of your mouth. What you say can be a blessing or a curse. The principles of sowing is not limited to our actions only. You don't only sow your time, your finances, but our sowing is also in our spoken words. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. Galatians 6, verse 7. Number 3, believe. What you believe, who you believe. It is important to know, you know, what you believe in and who you park your faith in. The world says, seeing is believing. But the Bible says, walk by faith, not by sight. And in Matthew 9:29, Jesus said, according to your faith, let it be to you. Now, in this scenario, Jesus healed the two blind men because they believed that Jesus can open their eyes. In the same way, the Bible mentioned in Matthew chapter 13, verse 58, now he did not do many mighty works there because of their unbelief. In this verse, not many miracles happened in Nazareth because the people there didn't believe him. It's sad, but it's true. So the truth is that if you don't believe in what you are praying, do you think your prayer will be answered? Maybe, maybe not. The Bible is very clear that if you believe, you will experience miracles in your life. Also, the Bible says in Romans 10:17, faith comes from hearing. Allow me to share my recent experience about this verse. Faith comes from hearing. This happened to me at the vaccination center recently. First of all, all my life, I dread going to any government agency or government hospital because of the long waiting hours. Imagine waiting for 3 hours in a hospital waiting to see the doctor. And when you are there with the doctor, the consultation is over within 10-15 minutes. 3 hours, you sit there waiting. And then 10-15 minutes, it's over. That's why I feel I dread going to any of these government agencies or anything related to do with the government offices. But this one is different, or was different. The moment I walk in to the building for the first dose, the ushers there greeted me, "Uncle." Everybody. I thought, okay, never mind. I bear with it. And I don't need to tell you, I don't need to explain to you why they call me uncle. Someone even asked me if I could walk or do I need a wheelchair. My heart just sank. Really? Earlier it was uncle, now a wheelchair? How depressing can it be? But anyway, once I got the queue number, going in, going forward, I found people calling me uncle. This way please, uncle sit here please, uncle wait there, for there please. Uncle this, uncle that, everywhere uncle, uncle, uncle. But I realized one thing. Every time they call me uncle, it is time to move along, move forward. It is good news. Hearing uncle is good news. Right? So, hearing this word as they call me uncle made me believe good news is coming. And at that moment, I chose to believe it. So I just said to the Lord, "Lord, if calling me uncle gets me out of this place quickly, get it over and done with quickly, make them call me more. I want to hear more. I can take it." From that moment, I arrived at the vaccination center until I sat down to be jabbed. It was all about 15 minutes. It was quick, I must admit. Now my second dose completed even faster. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. But the thing here is this, the point here is this, hearing and faith. This is my experience. After hearing, I chose to believe. I said a little prayer, give thanks to the Lord. And the whole process didn't take long. I reached my destination, I got out of the place, got it done, over and done with. Amen. And last week, we heard about how God healed Brother Anthony's family from COVID-19 in India. Some of us also heard about our dear Pastor David's healing several months ago, how God healed some nerve issues in his fingers that was twitching uncontrollably. The fact is this, they believe God can heal. And the Lord healed them because they believe. Hallelujah. Then again, we must also take precautions because in 1 John chapter 4 verse 1 it says, "Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits, whether they are from God, because many false prophets have gone up into the world." So sometimes we need to test what we believe to see if it's from God. If you happen to believe in what is false to be true, you will be misled, you will be misguided, tragedy can happen. And worse, you may open the door for the devil to play with your mind and to control your mind. Amen. I hope this message will prompt us to look inwards towards ourselves on what shapes us. Take this time, spend a bit of time, think about it. Brothers and sisters, don't take it lightly because you become whatever that shapes you. Your feelings, your speech, your beliefs will mold you, whether for the better or for worse. There are no two ways about it. It is your choice, and your choice will determine your destiny. Going forward, again, I urge you to take a step back, pause a little while, then to reflect. Does what you feel, what you speak, what you believe honor God? Pay attention to these details, and they will help you to position you to the next level, aligning with God's kingdom plans and purposes. You will be in a better position to preempt the devil's schemes, and may even find God overwhelming you with beauty instead of ashes, oil of joy instead of mourning. Yes, you will experience the joy of the Lord, and be strong in the Lord. Amen. God bless, and thank you for tuning in.
Good morning, church, and all our viewers. Thank you once again for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. And I hope that you are richly blessed by this week's service. And I hope that you are staying safe as well. And I take this time to thank all the presenters for their wonderful efforts, especially Brother Eric Ng for his wonderful presiding. Truly has given us a wonderful presiding, and we are very thankful for that. And also Sister Florence for her cheerful and blessed scripture reading. You're also blessed. And also Sister Maricel and Brother Carlos J for their wonderful worship leading. We're also blessed as we worship together with them. We're truly blessed by the presence of God and by the lyrics of the song. I also want to thank Pastor Ekfan from FGCCI Mustafa Park, Lahore, for his prayer for the nation of Afghanistan. Afghanistan is going through some political changes, and we need to keep Afghanistan in our prayers constantly. I also want to especially thank Brother Julius Bonifacio for his excellent and insightful and blessed exhortation entitled Overcoming Fear. And especially during this time, we need to really know and learn how to overcome fear. Praise God for his wonderful insight and his wonderful exhortation. Also, especially want to thank our speaker, a very dear and very special speaker this week, which is our FGCCI media producer, Brother William Yip himself. And today we are so thankful that he's our speaker and he's able to give us a wonderful message. And most of the time he's always doing the background work every week, sacrificially and diligently in producing our weekly media service. But this week he is our speaker, and he has shared with us a wonderful title, wonderful message entitled, What Shapes You? And in summary, I just want to read from Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 8 onwards. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth, and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Verse 11, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I send. I also want to read to you from Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. From these two scriptures, we can learn of much of God's wisdom. Especially in times of uncertainty and challenging times, which is like right now, we have to take hold of the promise in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord. When things are not certain or the future is not so clear, we have to put our trust in the Lord, knowing that God always knows what He is doing. God is never caught by surprise. Even this COVID virus may surprise us and the nations, but it didn't surprise God. God already knows it beforehand. And surely we have prepared solutions and answers for it. God, our God, is an all-knowing God. Nothing surprises Him. He may surprise us, but not our God. That's why we can put our trust in Him, because He has already prepared a solution for this situation or a solution for our challenging circumstances that we face. And as we read in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8 onwards, God's ways are not our ways. Sometimes we want the things to be done in our way. We want things to be done in certain manner, in certain fashion, but God always has His ways, and His ways are always higher. The scripture says that heaven is higher than the earth, God's ways are higher than our ways. And His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. And here in Isaiah 55, it talks about God always has planned to bless. That's why in Isaiah 55, in verse 10, it says, "For as the rain comes down, and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, or water the earth, and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I send it." God's ways and His thoughts are always to bring blessings and to prosper us as His children. So in Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11 says, you know, "For the thoughts that God has for us is not thoughts of evil, but good thoughts to bless us, to give us a future and a hope." So we can put our trust in the Lord, knowing that His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. His ways are higher than our ways. And most important of all, it is His plans is always to bless us and to prosper us, as God sent down the rain to water the earth, that it may bud and become fruitful. So God's word will not return to Him void, but it will prosper in the thing which He sent to. And even as we meditate on God's word and His promises, let that those words bless our heart. And it surely will bring forth prosperity and blessings in the future. Only remember to put our trust in the Lord and lean not on our own understanding. In all our ways, you know, commit our ways to the Lord and He will direct our path. God will be able to direct us and lead us into the path of blessings and prosperity and deliverance and favor. And I hope that this short summary will richly bless your hearts. And as usual, we're going to give our tithes and offerings to the Lord. Shall we bow our heads and pray? Heavenly Father, even as we lift up, Lord, our tithes and our offerings and love give before Thy throne of grace, bless the Lord His tithes and His offerings and His love give for the furtherance of Your kingdom and for the glory of Your name. Return back, Lord, Your blessings upon every giver who will give to You, Lord, cheerfully, willingly, and purposefully, God, 100-fold, 60-fold, and 30-fold. And may Your name be greatly magnified and glorified in the nations. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, church, and all our viewers once again for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. And as usual, before we conclude the service, we'd like to give you a benediction. Just close our eyes and hearken to the benediction for this week. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine upon you and be gracious towards you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and grant you peace. May the Lord stretch off His hands of favor and of blessings and of providence and of protections upon you and your family and your loved ones. May you put your trust in the Lord, knowing that His thoughts are higher than our thoughts, His ways are higher than our ways. Even as heaven is higher than the earth, and God's will is to prosper us, is to bless us, whatever seasons that we are in. We can put our trust in the Lord, and He will direct us into the path of blessings and prosperity and deliverance and great favor. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, church, and all our viewers once again for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. Hope to see you again next week. Next week is our communion service, so remember to prepare emblem of the cup and the bread, and even as we partake of the Holy Communion together for next week. So remember to stay safe and stay blessed and stay strong together in the Lord.